Today, 21st of May is the International Turtle Day, so let's talk about one of the most popular turtle pets in the world. Stay tuned to find out why and to learn more about taking care of red ear sliders. I'm Mario and this is From Animals. Red ear sliders are semi-aquatic turtles. Being able to walk on the ground, they are actually pretty fast compared to tortoises. They spend most of the time in water. They have webbed feet, being very good swimmers. Their name comes from those two red spots on their head and from the fact that they slide quickly from rocks in water when are scared. Other characteristics of red ear sliders are the yellow lines on their skin and the green carapace, which becomes darker as the turtle ages. In average, their carapace can have 15 to 20 cm in length, but some of them can grow larger than 40 cm. Mature females are mostly larger than males, which is a common thing in reptiles. Males have longer claws and larger tails, whilst females have shorter claws and small thin tails. Also, looking at the turtle's plastron, we can observe that females have a flat plastron, while male's plastron is a little bit concave, which is useful during mating, but you can find out the turtle's gender just when it is bigger. Males are sexually mature when they reach 10 cm in length or between 2 and 5 years, while females become sexually mature when their carapace is 15 cm long or when they are between 5 and 7 years old. After the male attracts the female with a weird dance and after mating, the female will lay between 2 and 30 eggs. When the weather gets colder, usually in October, the red ear slider begins to bramate in water. Bramation is similar to hibernation, but the red ear slider needs to go occasionally to surface, take oxygen, and drinks water. It won't eat until the weather becomes warmer. Red ear sliders originate from Southwest Colorado, Virginia, and Florida, but they became very popular pets during the last decades. People usually buy these turtles because they are cute when they are small, and because they can adapt easily to new climates. Quick fact, within the second volume of the Tales of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, the popular comic book heroes were revealed as specimens of red ear sliders. The popularity of these turtles led to a craze for keeping turtles as pets all over the world. So everything is fine for red ear sliders, right? Not really. A lot of people all over the world bought these turtles, but they didn't know that those small cute red ear sliders would grow that big. Also, these turtles can live a very, very long life. From 30 to even 70 years, depending on the conditions that they have in captivity. First of all, the lack of knowledge led to a lot of turtles dying in less than a year. Finding out that it is not that easy to take care of red ear sliders, a lot of people released them in lakes and ponds. Now these turtles can be found everywhere where the climate is warm enough, competing with other native species for food. Their import has been banned by the European Union. In Australia, it is illegal to import, keep, trade or release red ear sliders. So if you want to have a red ear slider as a pet, you should understand that they live a very long life and you have to offer them all the needed conditions. So I will tell you everything you need to know before buying a red ear slider. Let's set up the aquarium. The minimum volume for the aquarium for one turtle is 80 liters. Two of them can live pretty good in a 100 liter aquarium. Because you'll have to clean it very often, I recommend buying a small one at the beginning and to upgrade it to a larger one as the turtle becomes bigger. 2/3 of the terrarium should be filled with water. To find out the amount of water necessary for a good living, you can use this simple formula. The length should be 4 times bigger than the turtle's carapace, width twice bigger, and the depth of the water should be at least 1.5 times bigger. To determine the length of a red ear slider, you can use a compass and a ruler. By the way, the day of 23rd every month is considered the day of measuring red ear sliders. 1/3 of a terrarium should be a dry place. Red ear sliders like to stay on a dry place being warmed by a lamp, which is our next thing needed. To keep the water clean for a longer period of time, you should use a filter. Internal filters are cheaper, but they just accumulate the dirt into one corner, while external ones are more expensive, but will keep the water clean for a longer period of time. Also, you'll need a warmer and a thermometer to keep the water temperature around 25 degrees Celsius. If you have a possibility, I'd recommend building a small pond because the turtle will have more space, you won't need to change the water that often, and the red ear slider will get more sunlight, which is essential for its growth. But don't forget to build a high fence around the pond because they can climb very good. Also, when they are mature, they should have a place where to lay eggs. Now let's talk about their diet. When they are small, radio sliders will eat twice a day, being carnivores. Growing up, they'll become omnivores, and when they become mature, they eat mostly vegetables once in 2 or 3 days. So here is what they eat. From a live food, they can eat fish, earthworms, aquatic snails, crickets, shrimps, and sometimes cooked lobsters. From vegetables, they eat carrots, squashes, mustard leaves, turnips, green beans, sweet potatoes, dandelion leaves, apples, melon, bananas, berries, grapes, tomato plums, and peaches. Occasionally, you can give them cooked chicken meat. But the most common food found in pest traps are gramarus and these vitamin sticks. So, now that you know everything about red ear sliders, you can take care of your cute, curious, and interesting turtle pet, which will live with you happy for a very long period of time. If you enjoyed this video, give a like and subscribe to I'm From Animals for more upcoming videos. I hope my grandparents won't sue me for filming on their property.